Hello everyone, thanks for being here for this lecture at Documenta. Was expected to happen physically in Cassel, but unfortunately, because of COVID things, it happened now remotely. So I'm Thibault Lepage, I'm a drawer and design researcher. I'm very glad to be here, and I would like to thank Instar and Ernesto Rozza for the organization and the invitation. And so what I will discuss today is a lecture from a French book translated in the 80s of Sergei Tretiakov. And it will be interrogate with another lecture of another reading of an article of Marie Goff in October and anthropological issues of Arjuna Padwai in the social life of things. So maybe we can start the presentation if it's possible, the PDF. Thanks, Chris. To specify what I will talk about is a lecture about a traduction of a book mainly. So this book is called Dans le front gauche de l'art in French. And this is taken from an article that I published in Azimut 54, which is design magazine that we have in Cité du Design, École supérieure d'art design in Saint-Étienne in France. And we can switch to the next slide, maybe. And so this is Azimut. This issue was done with the help of many people, but for the graphic design is done by Carolina Borkowska and Sylvain Raymondon. We can go next slide, please. This lecture will be mainly about these three books, and the article that was published in Azimut is a kind of graphic synthesis of the lecture of these three books that you can see background of this presentation. And the book that you can see at right of the screen is the French translation of many texts of Tretiakov that was published in Lev, Novi Lev, but also elsewhere. And it was published by a French publisher, which name is François Maspero. And François Maspero is an interesting thing is that he was very involved in publication in France in leftist things, but also anarchist field, but many other things about social sciences and humanities. And he's one of the first publishers of Frantz Fanon in France. And this book so was done during the 80s. And an interesting thing is that Maspero had was managing a bookshop in Paris to get money to publish his book. And this bookshop have been closed part because of situationists were doing what they called permanent rent in this bookshop. So they were stealing books in this place. And Maspero was letting them do because he didn't wanted to intervene, so his bookshop was closed because of that. So to introduce what I will show, it's from it all started during in September 2020 during a discussion that we had with Ernesto Rozza. And during this discussion, we agreed that during the years to come, it would be useful to have a tool for delving into Sergei Tretiakov's writings on the notion of factography as developed by him. So, as a starting point for this work, I proposed a kind of format halfway between reading notes, summary, and cartoon index. And it consists of a sheet of A4 paper, complete as I read the works being documented. So this protocol of drawing is highlighting certain sentences and paraphrasing others. And the final collection does not synthesize the text, but rather attempt to accompany a journey through ideas to accompany a reading. So it's not a translation, but an attempt at arbitrary transduction, the gesture of transposing the content of one body into another. Thus, there is no real order, no chronology of reading, this project being modestly inspired by a description by Luc Moulet of Jean-Luc Godard's relationship to reading. I quote Luc Moulet, "He rarely reads a book in its entirety in life. It takes a few extracts, the best in principle, but sometimes it's a bit random. He pecks through books like a hen in a garden." So I was quite inspired by that to do this, to start this protocol of drawing and reading. And so this is starting with text dealing with the notion of factography translated by Henri Deluis and published by François Maspero, as I told. And my reading led me to a text by Maria Goff, which historically situated Tretiakov's work, as well as the notion of biography of the object, which seems to have been revisited by Arjuna Padurai and Igor Kopitov later, through the prism of cultural anthropology. So although this drawing were realized spontaneously as I read, are annotated so that one may find the argument mentioned in each edition. They have been drawn first and foremost to be read with floating and enduring attention. So what I will present today is a kind of montage of these drawings that I reorganized to be more linear and more fluid during a journey into Tretiakov's work. So to introduce, even if I know that you are with Instar working a lot on that for Documenta, Tretiakov was a Russian poet and writer born in Goldingen in 1892 and dead in Moscow in 1937. He have written theater plays, but today we will concentrate on text published which are giving interesting view about collective production of knowledge using material culture. And we will explore it firstly by seeing which critics Tretiakov addressed to the classical novel and the popular representation by authors. Then how his journey to Kolkhoz changed his way of working. Further, which proposal of work he drawn to produce collective representation. 12 knowledge, and we will finish by discuss his concept using Arjuna Padurai, Maria Goff, and Igor Kopitov reviews. So, as Henri Duluy, who translated this book in French, said, Tretiakov tried to reconceptualize the audience and the author-reader relationship. Tretiakov is also one of those for Duluy who have grasped the importance of the journalistic and literary forms which occupy a large place in contemporary production. This presentation is really done by a kind of very situated position. My position in France that where we have only this book of Tretiakov, some English texts that are very interesting to read too. But I didn't have access to the huge amount of text in Russian. And I know that you have many things about his work too. So I highly I'm really interested by your comments and by questions, but also references that I don't have. So feel free to speak about it in the comments on the with the video. We will discuss it after with pleasure. So to be clear, this presentation does not attempt to say that Tretiakov drowned the good way of doing, or that representation of novel is bad. The idea is more to ask what discourse can tell us his work regarding the present. I'm talking about that because mainly Tretiakov addressed a lot of critics to the traditional novels, and we will talk about this now. So we can maybe switch to the next slide. Thank you. So he had a very global position about literature, art, and a strong and provocative critique addressed to the classical novel. And for him, emotional literature lacked interest, and only factual literature was important. So we can switch to the other slide. So for him, the so literature about facts here. We can switch again to the other slide. And for Tretiakov, the classical novel is built on the biography of the individual hero. So he's like a hieroglyph. He sits upon a throne with tiny characters around him. So servants, wives, warlords. And for Tretiakov, this classical hero is a kind of rentier. So we can switch again. So we are not he's at the top of a kind of social pyramid. We are not talking about his profession or the technical aspects of his life, but about the way he kisses, about the way he kisses, about the way he eats, and about the way he dies. So this is a big critique he addressed to classical novels. So in a way, he's addressing the same kind of critics in a mirror to the writers of this kind of novel. So we can switch to the next slide. For him, those writers were the mirrors of their novel, presenting individual heroes. So for Tretiakov, the figure of the solitary writers is a kind of facing the collective brain of revolution. And he says that for him, life teachers, writers will be no more. So he addressed this critique to all the classical literature, which is in each place it's written. Russia, France is really addressing that to everything. And so with the other writers of the left, he proposed to replace the content of the work. He said that the main problem of the work is not the content, but its destination. So he says that it's not the subject to change, but the destination of doing the representation. So we can switch again to the next slide. He says that the writer's profession is applied to a kind of fetishized material. So we can switch now two times to drawing where people again. So the next drawing is just after. We can switch to it maybe. And thank you. And for Tretiakov, this all this relationship of that the writer, traditional writer profession is involving with readers is transforming the book into a kind of fetishized material. So we can switch again. So for him, everything has changed to make books since medieval epoch. The medieval messenger has become a kind of telephone operator. The monk copyist has become typographer. everything has changed, but the we can switch, please. And thank you. And the writers retain his style, his inspiration, and his production remains individual. So we can switch again. He addressed in a way this critique to cinema too. So for him, we don't need to change the subject of films, of movies, but we need to change the way that the film are made. And for him, someone who was doing that was Eisenstein with the Theater of Attraction that we will see after. Please switch. A big sentence that Tretiakov have in the book Dans le front rouge de l'art is that he says that a single technician is more useful than 10 bad poets. So for him, we don't need more bad poets, we don't need more writers, but we need to change the way that how the books are done, all the art form are done, and the non-specialists are highly needed into the production to provide material. And is only talking about people doing visual or textual production to record this material, and he called that people stabilizers. So people to stabilize in a form all the material that is coming from reality with facts, with conversation with people happening in the present time. What he tried to do to talk about all that and to improve, he went I know into China during a period to learn about Dazibao, for example, but he also mainly went to Kolkhoz to experiment with all this theory into real time, and we can switch the slide. And so for this part, I took a lot of documentation into an article from Maria Gauff, which was published in October. So the issue of the October that was shown at the debut of the lecture. And so for Maria Gauff, during the 20s and the 30s, forced collectivization of the Soviet Union and the industrial crash led to a kind of taste for tourism to industrial sites. So during this period, Tretiakov was visiting some Kolkhoz in the Caucasus, and that's where he developed two techniques for records, for his records. So it was photography and written essays. So he was better known as a photographer at the Kolkhoz. He wrote that because he was making pictures with the people. He was saying that one of the mainly interesting points of this technique was to show not only the work which was done into the fields, but also how the work should be done. So at the same time, documenting what is happening in the day, but also what should happen. So for Maria Gauff, this is where in the Kolkhoz that he experienced the limits of factography that was discussed with the member of Novilev, and that's where he started to talk about operativism. I profit of this moment to say that I forgot to say that my English is not is correct, but I know that I have a big accent, so. Unfortunately, we can't meet. But if something that I say is not clear, you can say it in the comments, and I will answer you after with pleasure. So in the Colcos, he start to talk about operativism. We can change the slides. So yes, it's a drawing that is appointing to what I was saying before. These two techniques, photography and writings. Into the farm, Tretiakov tried to participate to the tasks, to fix the facts without fantasy. And his principle went against both literature and psychologizing writing. And he was very advocating utilitarian journalistic work on socio-economical problems. So at this moment, he gave a kind of big consideration to the partial quality of photography, and even thinking about the waste of the photography, how Maria Gauff said. So he was feeling after his journey to the Colchos very very bad, because he was he thought that he was he wasn't he didn't took so much knowledge. He wanted really to be a participant during the tasks, and take more time there to understand that. That also in the Colchos, that he tried to start a kind of newspaper journal, which was called The Challenge. And with this journal, he was really appointing to this idea of collecting information, saying how things should be done. And that's it. He's really he have an interesting way of saying this way of working. He's talking about the writer as a psycho-engineer, and he says that this writer this ideal writer have to be on the field to do this record, and also to live in the Colchos. He also during this period wrote to Bertolt Brecht to talk about the Colchos, and saying that he must return there. I will talk mainly about proposition and prefiguration of collective action that he had to change the way of working. He addressed mainly this kind of proposition of collective action as an answer to the critics he done about the classical novel. And for him, the only case in which the writers connect to the reality is when he's connecting to another profession, which is the reporter chronicler, so someone doing journalism on the fieldwork. And he transcribes this idea he's managing this, he's using this idea of reporter chronicler with the idea of the redaction on the collective work that happened in a publication of a newspaper. So he said that the writer, when he's working, is alone, but the journalist, the reporter chronicler, to publish in the newspaper, he have to be taken into a collective stream where he talks with other people that are asking many things about about his text. So he's saying that the object of the newspaper is putting people in another way of collaborating and producing a form. He rejects the in this way he reject the literary method of studying 10 individuals to create one 11th individual. So maybe we can switch to the other slide. And he prefers journalism, which finds in reality the concrete figures, characteristics of a given series on which can become generalization. So mainly said that this drawing is pointing to that when you are studying a lot of people to create a kind of big persona of all these people, you are erasing many things, and that with the reporter chronicler methods and with the journalism, you can find this idea of speaking about everyone. So the collective representation happen when the confrontation of all these views are made in the text. So not about creating another character, but about confrontation of many views in one text or in one representation. So in my case, when I first read that, I automatically thought about the TV channels, 24 on 7 day TV channel that we have now during the present. And if we are kind of provocative, we can say to Tretiakov that his dream became true. But of course, TV channels are made in another way, which is more made with attraction points, where everyone is going to the same place and doing this representation with the same points of representation, so everyone is replicating the same image. But Tretiakov is of course appointing to this kind of process, but applying in local things and that are put in a kind of networks, but that are multiply in many places and not just many people in the same places. So this is not the same the same way, but it was just for the provocation. So and a big object that that he's talking was so the newspaper. So we can go to the next image, to the next slide. So he for Tretiakov, the idea is really to use the newspaper as a kind of tool to produce a kind of tension in the present. And for him, the production of the newspaper is transforming the moment of the representation and the writing, and also what is happening in the moment of this collective representation. And that's what he developed after with operativism, but we will come to this after. So we can switch to the other slide. And for him, he said that we have nothing to. I quote him. He said that we have nothing to expect from the Red Tolstoys. For him, the epic is here, and this epic is the newspaper. So the way of doing a kind of big narrative is the actuality on the quotidian newspaper. So this is connected to the idea that ideology is not in the content, but in the material, in the process of its transformation. And for example, changing the contents of a novel serves no purpose, but you have to change the container. So that's what he was mainly talking about. And another interesting comparison that he did about that, he said that the newspaper is what the Bible was for the peasants, and is also what the didactic novel was for the intelligentsia. For him, the newspaper is a kind of guide into everyday life for each event. So that's why for him it's really a kind of a popular representation and popular way of doing narrative. We can switch to the other slide. He said for that mainly the a kind of lack that he identified when he was writing about that. He said that the party at this époque had powerful statistical tools, but the writer for him works in an unscientific and irrational and intuitive way, and to bring this all this knowledge into the production, the solution is the newspaper. So for him, only the newspaper is solving this problem through production, since it is the product of many hands. We can switch to the other slide, and that's in this way that the stabilizers is talking about. And we were I was appointing before are important because he really says that these hands are really important to create this collective content that is the newspapers. So he was even about the newspaper thinking about the display of the production of this object and how this display can change the way of producing together on how material can impact knowledge. And in this way, he was thinking about mural journal made with newspaper. And is interesting because in the text that I have read about that, he mainly said that this idea come from a demand from consumer, from people in the mail that the party received, and he opened the mail, and he developed this idea of the newspaper at mural from a kind of ask that was addressed by a consumer who was asking that to avoid general drunkenness on the payday. So he was thinking that this tool of the mural newspaper was a way to say how to people how to spend money well. So I think after I developed this idea of mural newspaper in other ways, but mainly in the text that I have read, it comes from this kind of demand. So for him, challenge the newspaper was doing this kind of was appointing to this kind of ID, but I don't I'm not reading and speaking Russian, so I'm really interested if some of you have ideas of or understand well this subject. We can switch to the other image, which is pointing to this idea of mural journals. Sorry, I'm a bit late on the PDF. And we can switch again to the image, which is pointing to this idea of theater of attraction that developed Eisenstein. And for Tretiakov, it's a bit the same thing as the newspaper, in a way that he says that it's a mean of class action. And for Tretiakov, Eisenstein's theater takes the audience to be part of the performance. So it's connecting to his idea of producing this newspaper together to produce collective knowledge and collective action. So for him, the theater of attraction is taking the audience to and exercising on it a kind of series of pressure on the psyche of the spectators with theatrical devices, but modifying the collective action after. So we can switch to the other image, and which is pointing to factography. And so this is a very simple drawing, which is synthesizing this idea. So this is another tool in complementary of the newspaper, of the journal, which is just describing in a collective retranscription of facts that are happening, and producing a kind of collective registration of these facts. So that's what we try to do with Ernesto Roza on the CIDR, the third cycle of ESADS during the design biennale. But I know that also that you are trying that you are doing here. So I'm really curious about how it works for you there. And so what Tretiakov said and understood doing that is that factography wasn't enough to modify how the action and how the things are working, and bring this concept of connect this concept of operativism that I know that that's also what we are trying to do here, and what you are trying to do, what you are doing in Documenta. So it's really interesting to talk about that. For him, operativism is like a factography, but considering we can switch to the other drawing. Operativism is considering the fact that a present tense is produced by the collective documentation. So it's modifying how reality is working during this present. So it drives to a kind of collective hermeneutic and modifying the way the people are working, the way the people are talking, the way the people are doing things together. So this collective registration and the collective regards of this registration is modifying what and how we register, but also how we talk, how we do things. And so mainly Tretiakov said that to invent there is literature. To discover an important theme, there is reporting, and to construct together an important theme, there is operativism. So he said that is a way to produce the thematics this way too. Also in a direct answer to the classical novel, for Tretiakov, when we start to speak about material life, production of things, and even doing it together, we are getting away from a classical novel and the self-centered expression of emotion, and going to what he called biography de l'objet. And we can switch to the image. And for him, the biography de l'objet produce a kind of chain along which the material advances and make it possible to exit subjective emotion by placing the narrative on the side of the object rather than that of the emotions. So by talking about an object together, by creating it or documenting it, we are creating a narrative that is not centered on us, but on how the subject speaks about us for itself. In this way, for him, idealist philosophy has forced its will upon the novel. It has lost interest in social professional illnesses, and novels speak only about hunger and love. And this way of describing objects and talking about it is speaking about new things. And he mainly says, we can switch to the other slide, that books in this way, in a biography de l'objet way, like paper, forest, wheat, factory, have not been written. And according to Tretiakov, they must be written via this idea of biography de l'objet. Today there is many many people that where we can find we can think that they are working in this kind of way when they are when for example anthropology or even in art or design field when we are mapping on the on describing the all the journey of a material through many his raw source to what he became after when we modify it, but also when he's trash or he became something else could be seen. This ideas could be seen in continuity of this idea of write books about paper, wheat, forest, and factories. It's very, very connected to this idea. So it's interesting to see that now it's taken by art, but also anthropology and many other disciplines fields. Now I will talk a bit about how this notion of biographical object was taken by Arjuna Padurai and Igor Kopitov. I will talking about now is a comparison of their discourse with the one of Tretiakov did. Their discourse is from a book which is called Social Life of Things in English, but in France, so I think in this English version, it was done in 86 or 84, maybe I mistake. And in France, we had a translation in 2020, I guess. I was very interested by that because when I was reading this book of Tretiakov, I have read this other two, and Apadura is not quoting this book if I will remember Tretiakov, but he's using the same terminology. He's using this idea of biography de l'objet, the text of Igor Kopitov is also pointing in the same kind of things. It's interesting because they talk about this idea about this they use the same term but in another economical regime because they wrote this book from Occident, I guess, even if many other people from other places talk about that for them, they are more talking. They are talking in the same way about this idea of. They use this word of commodity, but it's appointing same time to how the things is are produced and how the things are consumed. Apadurai, things in turn leave the commodity state in phases. He also postulates that objects circulate in different value and regime in the space-time and in very specific cultural and historical milieux. Commodities are the common focus of interest of many disciplines with which record them in different ways. So we can switch to the other slide. And so the commodity so the commodifying context contributes to defining the value of an object. And for example to contrary to what occurs in a domestic place will exacerbate the commodity dimension of an object. Mainly, Apadurai and Kopitov are pointing to a kind of distinction that Jacques Marquet done in 1971, which is dividing goods into four categories. We can change. We can switch to the next slide. To goods by destination, goods by metamorphosis, ex-goods, or goods by diversion. And the comparison with Tretiakov is interesting because they extend the idea of biography of the object to the state of its circulation and to its consumption. If Apadura is distinguishing two types of knowledge, technical, social, aesthetic, and which are kind of linked to production knowledge and consumption knowledge. So the first is a kind of interpretation given to the commodity, and the second is a kind of received interpretation. So he thinks that is a kind of mistakes to consider production knowledge as exclusively technical or empirical, and consumption knowledge as exclusively appreciative and ideological. So for him, all these layers are superposed, and that's why it's really connected to a bit to the idea of the biography of l'objet, as Tretiakov discusses it, because he's pointing to what happened when people discuss about this one object. So is really connected to what happened to the object, how is registered, on which narrative are pointing to that. They are also talking about the next talk. We can switch to the next slide, and which is pointing to this idea of technical biography, sociological biography, and social biography, which is a kind of filtering all this way of what happened to something which is done technically, but also which move after in society, and on how people are talking about it, using it, and and presenting it. So here is a pointing, I guess, to, I don't well remember if this drawing is a pointing to the Apadura part of Kopitov, because Kopitov is more talking about this idea of establishing biography of vehicles to reveal how a vehicle is acquired, how and by whom the money was raised to pay for it, and the relationship between buyers and sellers, the use to which it is put, the identity of passenger and the frequency, but also the garage where it's repaired and always disposed when it becomes a wreck. So it's really superposing all these layers. So I think this idea in opposition of to what Tretiakov is calling biography of the object, where everyone knows and participates to the construction and the construction of an artifact, there is a kind of mythologies that can appear if a commodity bridge is quite long. We can switch maybe two slides after. Thank you. We can switch to the after because I already passed that. Yes, is interesting, is something that is discussed by Apadura and Kopitov too, is this idea of commodity bridge, which is something that they explain by the idea of more the place where something is made is far than the place where people use it. More you have a kind of mythologies that appears because you have a kind of narrative recording of what the subject is from, and they call it a kind of commodity bridge. And so for Tretiakov, this is interesting because when you are using this idea of biography of l'objet to talk about an object and to produce it, to use it, and to record at the same time, when you are in the same moment or connected in a way, making your own kind of collective narrative, which is not superposing and iterating many times with the circulation. So this is a kind of interesting point that I see in the comparison of these two lectures of geographic object. So that's it. Maybe we can switch to the last slide. Thank you. I was really happy to talk there, even if the conversation that was that will maybe happen in the comments and not physically in Kassel, but maybe another time we will discuss about all that. So thank you and have a good day. Bye.